So Diwali is all around the corner, and very quickly there's flashy card parties that keep everybody on their toes, and there's obviously a lot of gold for everybody to enjoy in terms of jewelry, in terms of idols. Personally, I feel that gold is a much safer investment. You can see it, you can hold it. However, stock market is all up in the air and you don't know which way it's going to go. Let's find out what exactly is a better and a safer investment option. So Monika, please tell us, which one is better, gold or the stock market?
I've heard a lot of things in the last 1 minute. Stock market is a gamble, gold is safe, you can hold it. Some of these are okay and some of these are not. So I will just start by looking at some return numbers. Now, if you're thinking of an investment, we always need to think about a return. If you invested in gold in the go-go gold days of 2007, by 2012 to 2017, you would have lost 5,000 rupees on a 1 lakh investment. You've actually lost money in gold if you bought at a particular time.
Okay.
The same time, Sensex had given you an 11% return. Your 1 lakh had gone to 1.6 lakh in the same period. Take other cuts of time, 10 years, 15 years, 20 years. The gold return has been between 8 and 11% for the different time periods. In each of these time periods, the Sensex return has been more. All right, so it is incorrect to say that gold will always give you a great return.
Okay.
But if you invest correctly, then you can get a better return on the stock market.
But what about safety? I mean, at least I get something back, right, with gold?
Yeah, safety, all right. But the numbers are actually a little worse.
Okay.
So you said that people wear the gold and, you know, you think you've made an investment when you buy a gold chain. But the minute you walk out of the jeweler's showroom, you've lost 30% of the value. If you buy jewelry as investment, there's something called making charges, right? So when you do making charges, you have lost 30% of the value. So gold is not a good investment through jewelry, right? And so gold is an asset which doesn't really throw off a rent, an interest, a dividend.
Right.
The only thing you get is a profit, which means when the price changes from 100 to 150, 50 rupees is your profit. But when you buy a house, it has a return in terms of rent. Stocks will give you a dividend. A fixed deposit gives you interest. Gold is one asset that does not throw off a regular income.
So is gold not an investment?
That's the thing. There are no straight answers. Gold is to be used for a portfolio for diversification, which means you reduce the risk of a portfolio by putting about 10% of gold. So if your portfolio value is 100, 10 rupees worth is gold, right? And it also, and so why do we have this gold in the portfolio? It is a hedge against inflation, which means that it protects your money against inflation also. Yeah.
And what is the best way perhaps to buy
own gold? Jewelry, of course it is not. People used to buy gold bars and coins, but then there is a cost of storage and all of that.
Yeah.
The best way today is to buy the sovereign gold bonds that the government is issuing. So the government of India is issuing these bonds, and it's actually giving you a 2.5% return at the moment on the bond. So you buy the bond, you get a regular interest, and when you want to redeem and sell, you will get the gold price of that time, whether it is 3 years later or 5 or 10 years later, you will get the then current gold price. So the best way to hold gold as 10% of your portfolio is through the sovereign gold bonds in India today.
Okay, so gold jewelry is not an investment.
Enjoy it, wear it. I love to wear gold jewelry. But it's not. I'm not counting it as my portfolio. Okay?
Fantastic. Okay, so gold should not be more than 10% of my investment portfolio.
Correct.
All right. And the only way that I should look at it is through the government bonds, which you've made at the moment. But this might change in the long term.
See, the financial sector constantly innovates.
Right.
So if you had asked me this 2 years back, I would have said the exchange traded fund is the best way.
Right.
A gold ETF.
Right.
But then the government came and launched these bonds, and this has become better.
Yeah.
So it's a moving target.
Right. That makes a lot of sense. I still have some doubts, but I think we'll keep talking about this. Now let's take a viewer question.
Hi Monika, I have a question for you. I want to invest in a short term. I'm going to go for a short term investment. Bank advisor advised me to go for a portfolio management service. However, he said that the risk is as bad as equity. And I'm not sure whether I want to go for that. Can you suggest me some?
Right, it's a good question. And there is a whole lot of push towards the product called PMS. As the mutual fund rules are getting tighter, a lot of advisors are pushing people towards PMS. For a first-time entrant into stock markets and investing, the PMS is not the way to go. She should just stay with mutual funds. If she's not invested, she should find a good advisor and start investing through mutual funds. Remember that the PMS is for the higher net worth individual investor. Your entry level starts at a portfolio of 25 lakh. Right, so your risk will be lower, your products are cheaper when you go through the mutual fund. So don't get greedy, stay with funds, stay with lesser risk rather than targeting a higher return, paying a higher fee and exposing your money to something that you don't even understand.
All right. Well, in case you have any further queries, you can write to us at moneywithmonika@livemint.com and you can also tweet to us @livemint.